God is awesome. God is awesome. This is the day that the Lord has made, and we ought to rejoice and be glad in this day. Just take a look around. Say, wow, all of this is going on. And God speak. Blessing me. People are dying every day. People are leaving here. And the question comes, why God keeping me here? It's not time to die. God is so awesome in everything that he does. There's no failure in God. It's time to raise a praise. Lift him high. Give him all the glory and honor, because it truly belongs unto him. Father God, our Lord and our Savior, Father, we ask you now to let the words of our lips, the meditation of our heart, Lord, be accepted within our sight. Oh Lord, my Savior, my Redeemer. Father, reach out now, touch those that don't understand what you're doing. Heal broken hearts right now. Ease troubled minds, weary souls. Let us know, Lord, that you're still on the throne, and there's nothing too hard for you. Somebody right now feel like giving up, feel like throwing in the towel, because they don't understand, Lord, that you're not gone, but you're still working. In the name of Jesus, touch some father right now that want to walk away from his family. Touch him right now. Tell him to hold on. Help is on the way. Touch some mother that is so confused right now because the children is home. The pressure of life is setting in. The job is gone. But Lord, you're still here. In the name of Jesus. Touch right now. Touch men, broken family, broken home. Men, fathers and sons and mothers and daughters and fathers and mend them right now. In the name. Lord God, we give your name all the glory and all the praise. In Jesus' name we say, amen. And thank God.
Yes, Lord.
Surely this is the day that the Lord has made. I bring the greetings from Man of God Missionary Baptist Church. God is so great and so awesome. I want to give you a good word today, because that is a word from the Lord. Even in the midst of this crucial dark hour that we are facing, there's still a word from God. I feel like helping me now. I know the word is going to help you because it's helping me. We all need help. I thank God for his word. Because I like what the Bible say that everything shall pass away, but my word, said the Lord, shall stand. Thank God for the word.
Yes.
When I can't see it, it's still working. Mm-hmm. When I don't understand it, it's still working. Mm-hmm. When I don't even have enough in me to read it, it's still working. Heaven and earth shall pass away before one jot or one tittle, this word turns unto God. Boy, good God, that's a promise. That's something you can look forward to, that the word is going to carry us through. I want you to listen. Please, ma'am, please, sir, no matter how you're hearing me or watching me during this hour, I want you to give me just a little bit of your undivided attention for just a few minutes, and I promise you I'll let you go. I want talk to all of us, including myself. I want you to go with me to the book of Psalms. The book of Psalms, Psalms number 13. Yes, Psalms number 13. Yeah, there's 150 of them, but we want to rest our eyes on Psalms number 13. Psalms number 13 falls right after Psalms number 12 and right before Psalms number 14. In the middle of those two, you should find Psalms number 13. Here is a question that the entire world is asking God right now. The saved, the unsaved, and everybody in between is asking God the question that's right here in Psalms number 13. Look, if you will, at verse number 1. Here's a question that the world is asking God. How long will thou forget me, O Lord? Forever, how long will thou hide thy face from me? Question. We're asking God a question. How long should I take counsel in my soul, having sorrow in my heart? Daily question, Lord. How long? Have you forgotten about me? What's going on? Lord, how long should I have problems? How long shall my enemy be exalted over me? Question. These are questions that the entire world is asking God. Lord, how long will the virus be here? How long will the pandemic be here? How long should I be isolated? How long should I be quarantined? How long should I be without a job? How long will there be no more Lysol? How long will there be no more alcohol? How long? That is a question. Lord, have you forgot about me? What a question. Consider, hear me, O Lord. My God, light my eyes, lest I sleep the sleep of death. Lest my enemy say I have prevailed against him, and those that trouble me rejoice when I am moved. Lord, the enemy think they're winning. They think they're going to take me out. But I trust in thy mercy. Thy heart shall rejoice in thy salvation. Lord, I'll do it. Lord, I'll sing a song unto you, Lord, because thou hast dealt bountifully with me. What a word. What a question. Let me preach to thee, if you don't mind, from the simple subject. Lord, did you forget about me? Oh, what a question. Lord, did you forget about me? That's the question. That's what's in the atmosphere right along with the pandemic, right along with the virus. Lord, have thou forgot about me? Did you turn away from me, Lord? Am I all by myself? What a question. A question that all that God can answer. And the world right now needs an answer. We need an answer because everybody right now is full of agony, pain, discomfort. The saved is upset. The unsaved is upset. The just is upset. The unjust is upset. Everybody is angry, mad. Don't nobody understand where and why and what caused this to happen. God has a way of getting our attention by any means necessary. God knows how to get your and get my attention even when we don't want to give it to him. Lord, did you forget about me? I lost my job. I haven't got my stimulus check yet. My bills is due. Don't have enough food in the house. Rent's due. Car note due. Children acting up. Husband acting up. I'm acting up. Lord, did you forget about me? Me. Me. Man, the walls in the house is closing in. Everything is bothering me. I just can't find no peace. I can't go outside. I don't have a mask. I'm upset. Facebooking, tweeting, Instagram? No answer. Call my local officials. Nobody's in office. Everybody working from home. I call to get help. I hear babies, cats, dogs in the background. Short answers, no long-term solutions. Lord, please tell me you have not forgot about me. I'm going through something here. I'm going through. Seems like I'm going through it all. Locked in, spending hours with people that don't want to be locked in with me. That's a bad feeling. I'm eating with people that don't want to eat with me. I'm sitting down with folks don't want to be in the same room with me. We can't even agree on watching a television show together. We listen to the wrong music, the wrong TV show. Lord, I just need an answer. Have you forgotten about me? Me. Lord, have you forgotten about me? And I feel that you've forgotten about me because, Lord, yes, I know. I know I didn't go to church like I should. And I know I didn't give my tithe like I should. And I didn't give no offering, no talent, no time. But this is one of those times I can't wait till the church open back up. I just believe I need to go to church because, man, seems like everything's going wrong and ain't nobody telling me how to handle what's going on. Lord, have you forgotten about me? And I'm puzzled and I'm baffled, Lord. I'm not being disgruntled. I'm just don't understand. They closed the church, but they left the liquor stores open. I'm confused. Lord, did you forget about me? It's a virus. It's a virus. It's a virus. It's a virus, it's a virus, and the virus is worldwide, it's a virus. Lord, why is it here? Where did it come from? I think I tell you, I found out where it come from. I told you, I can tell you how long it's been here. It's always been here. We just didn't pay attention. Well, I think I will. The virus ain't nothing new. What do you mean? What do you mean, Plumber? The virus ain't nothing new? No. Some of us have had the virus so long we don't even know we had it. We've always been mean, dishonest, displeasing, doing things that's not right with God. That's the virus. That's the same thing. The virus. And some of us are so infected, we don't know that we have always been infected. All because we don't show love one to another. We don't uplift those that are less fortunate than we are. We've always had the virus to call. We'd rather divide than to come together. We'd rather tear down than to build up. We'd rather tear somebody's name down to esteem them. And how on earth because of the virus, I need to know, Lord, have thou forgotten about me? Because I'm going through it. I hear you. I see you. I know. I see you right now. I said, Lord, I'm all isolated. I'm here by myself. I can't move. But don't you know, the Bible says, the Bible, not me, but the Bible, says that he that has an ear, let him hear. That don't mean male, that's male and female. Let you hear what the Spirit of God is saying to the church. What is it saying, Pastor Plumber? It says, seek ye first the kingdom of God in all of his righteousness and all his other things. Thank God. We're adding among trees, but whenever you turn from God, that's automatically a pandemic. That's automatically a virus that only God can cure. Only God can cure. So you wonder, Lord, have you forgotten about me? And God is saying, no, I've never forgotten about you. And I believe I'll be honest and tell you, but you forgot about him. Yes. Do y'all hear what I'm saying?
Yes.
Because I heard God said, Lord, those that you put in my hand,
yes,
the devil in hell can't fuck them out. So God has never, ever forgotten about us. But how many times we turned and forgotten about God? What do you mean I forgot about God? He said, keep the Sabbath day holy.
Yes, yes.
We'd rather go fishing, go to a party, have a barbecue, have a fish fry, do anything rather than keep that day holy. He gave you 6 days to handle your business. And you mean to tell me the little business that you have, you can't get it together in 6 days? You got to take the only day he asked you for is 1 day. All of you need to be honest with yourself. God never turned from us, but all of us sometime or another that turned from God. So ask the real question, Lord, what do I need to do to come back to you? Oh, I feel like preaching hell before. You said, Lord, have you forgotten about me? And Lord said, no. Mm-hmm. I didn't forget about you.
Yes.
But my heart is broken because you forgot about God. What do you mean? Whenever things are going well, you don't call it. When the bank account look good, you don't bless it. When the car is running good, you go by the church, not to the church. Y'all ain't talking to me. When the refrigerator and the deep freeze running over, you don't give to those that really hungry. You storing up for the long haul. And did not the Lord say that the strong should bear the infirmity of the weak? Mm-hmm. Preach, boy, I believe I will, because you want to know, have God forgotten about you? No! But we all forgotten about him because we won't keep God's commandment. Love one another as I have loved you. God is still the same today, yesterday, and forever.
Yes.
He's a God that will not change. Mm-hmm. He's a God that you can't put in a hurry.
Right.
My big mama say he's a God. Whenever you talk to him, you don't have to worry. Because he's all seeing. Mm-hmm. He's all knowing.
Yes.
He is King of Kings. He's Lord of Lords.
Mm-hmm, yes.
He is the great I am.
Yes.
You don't have to worry. God have always, and he will keep on continually, mm-hmm, making ways for his children.
Yes.
Oh, I wish y'all talk to me. Believe me when I tell you, no matter how dark it looks, God still has a light,
yes,
shining in darkness.
Yes, yes.
I feel some of y'all, whenever the weight of the world is upon your shoulders, learn how to put it on God's shoulders.
Yes.
When you've got too much to handle, shift that thing. Say, Lord, this is too much for me, but it ought to be just right for you.
Yes, yes.
That's why the question was asked, is there anything too hard for God?
Yes.
And can't you hear God waving the flag and saying, no, there's nothing too hard for me. The big, the in-between, and the small. God said, I can handle all of your problems.
Yes.
Good God of mine, I want you to know that no matter what it looks like,
yes,
God has not forgotten about you. No matter what comes your way, no matter what you're faced with, no matter what you're going through, God has never forgotten about us because we was bought with a blood price. I feel that preaching that here. I come to tell you, God can't forget about us because his blood was shed for us. God will never turn his back on his blood. sin, he blesses the blood. Preach, boy, I just want you to know God hadn't forgot about you. You said, well, yes, he did, because I'm in prison. But the blood covered you even while you were in prison. The blood is covered you while you're under the bridge. The blood is covered you while you're sleeping in an old family car. The blood is covered you while you're in an old apartment building. The blood is covered you when you're big mama house, auntie house, and nobody house. The blood is covered because God cannot forget the blood.
My Lord.
What? Can wash away my sins. Nothing
but the blood.
But the blood of Jesus.
Yes, yes.
How long, Lord? How long? How long will you keep forgetting about me? The Lord said, what do you mean? How long? You looking at this thing from hour to hour, day by day. God is looking at eternity.
Yes.
You worried about something so minute, God had to put it on a microscope to see what you're complaining about, what you're crying about. Let me give you some good news before I leave you. I heard an old preacher told me one time, he said, son, I had so many problems. I didn't know what to do. He said, I got a phone call. I had to go out of town, so I had to go down and catch a plane. He said, when I got on the plane and sat there for a while, and then we made our way out to the runway, told us to buckle up our seatbelts. He said, in the plane, start taxing the plane, got a certain amount of speed in the plane, pulled up in the air. Everybody leaning back, the plane got up about 45,000 feet in the air, and God told me to look. Look down at your problem. And the problem before I got on the plane was bigger than me and the airplane. But after being about 45,000 feet, that God said, look out the window down at your problem. Preacher said he lifted up the shade on the airplane window and looked down, and to his surprise, everything was so small, he couldn't even see it. Lord God, that's how God is with our little small problems. God sets high, and then God looks down low. And God said, you crying about a $5 light bill. I can't even see what you're really crying about. Because he said, don't you know to cast all your cares upon him? Because he cares for you. Is there anybody listening to me? Look at me right through the lens of the camera. And I believe I'll talk to you for a minute. Have God, how long forgot about you? But I bring you good news from the house of God, and I know I got to go home. I wish I could stay here a little while longer, but I know you got things to do, and I'm gonna turn y'all to loose here. But before I leave, can I just talk to you for a minute? And I'm going to take my seat. Lord, have mercy. I hear you saying, God forgot about me. Why you saying God forgot about you? You told me God had to forget about me because they cut off my stamps. They cut off my job. I don't have no money. My stimulus check ain't came. Y'all ain't saying nothing. I can't get to the food bank because it got certain hours. Mortal got limited transportation. Y'all ain't saying nothing. I don't have a credit card. I can't get a Uber. And I can't get a Lyft. All because God done forgot about me. I believe I'll move just a little bit farther.
the world, and they just tell me, good evening, y'all ain't saying nothing. Oh Lord, God set the count of a thousand hills in his, the copper, the silver, the gold, the diamonds, the sapphires and the rubies, they belong to God. Y'all ain't saying nothing.
You can't go nowhere. You can't go up.
But you can go down. Kneel down. Make an altar in your heart. And tell God all about it. He already knows. He's never going to hear from you. Young man, tell God how you feel about your family. Tell God about it. Young man, tell God about it. Tell God how you feel. He sees you struggling with the kids. Tell him about me. He sees you struggling with your addiction. God ain't forgot about you. God want to help you, but you got to confess with your mind and believe in your heart. God will help you. God help you. Your voice ain't always answered. God's the best reconciler. Judge, I know. Got to tell God about it. When you tell God about it, you'll be like the last person. Psalm 13. When God do anything for you, you know what you got to do with God? When God bless you beyond your wildest imagination. Now he was saying, Dr. Plumber, what I need to do. I got the news for you. You need to sing him a song. A song of appreciation. A song of gratitude. A song saying, Lord, I thank you for all that you've done. Lord, I pray for what you're going to do. And then be honest and say, now, Lord, if you don't do anything else, you already done enough for me. Good God, on high. And if you really feel good, take a break from Vicky Winans. And this is what Vicky told me to tell you.
But every now and then, we got to go back home school.
listen. I want you to listen to me. You might be listening to me. You might be looking at me. God ain't forgotten about us.
Hallelujah.
What do you mean, Pastor Plumber? The Bible. The Holy Bible says, make your request known unto God. What do you mean, make it known? Tell it. I don't know Bible talk. He don't want Bible talk. He won't understand. Lord, I am an alcoholic. Lord, I am a drunkard. Lord, I am a murderer. Lord, I am a liar. I'm a backbiter. I'm a troublemaker. I'm a messed up. I'm a hell and lie carrier. God said, come unto me. All ye that live and heavy laden. Come out. And I'll give you some rest. God said, I'll fix that thing for you. Confess with your mouth. Believe in your heart. God said, he'll forgive you any of your sins. Fathers, ask God for forgiveness. Go be a father to your children. Husbands, go back and be a husband to your family, to your wife. Sons, be sons. Daughters, be daughters. Go home. Go home. God ain't forgotten about you, just got grown for a time. Go home. So what? You locked up in prison. You said you can't go home. Make where you at your home. Make an altar right there in the cell. Tell God, Lord, it's me. I need you now. I'm tired of living the way I'm living. I'm tired of feeling the way I feel. God, I need you right now. God is here. He's listening. He's listening. He's listening. He's listening. And those of you that are sitting in the luxury, comfortable, convenience of your homes, don't get so flush thinking that you're all of that. Don't do that. Don't play games with God. Because Job told me to tell you something. Job told him to tell you these words. And I asked your wife, he said, they need to know. The Lord giveth, and the Lord taketh away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Job went from the richest man in the land of all to the poorest man in the whole region. The Lord giveth, the Lord taketh away. Just like the Lord took, the Lord gave him double and triple for his struggle. God has not forgotten about us. I want to hug all of you. I want to hug you right now. Today. God is holding all of us in his arms. He's holding us right now. No matter what you've done, no matter what you said, be big enough to say, forgive me. A big person said, I'm sorry. I was wrong. Forgive me. And God's love immediately start back to front. God has not forgotten all us. He still loves us. He still cares. Though the church is open. Though the church is open, no matter where you are. You can come to Christ just where you are. Make up your mind. Make up your mind. It's yours. You have that right. You have that opportunity. Don't let this end without you making a decision. I need God. God don't need me. He hasn't forgotten about me because he's keeping you alive. No matter what state you might be in, what condition that you're in, God is keeping you alive. Would you please come? Would you come unto him? Come if you would come. Would you come? If you have any children, would you come? Can't wait till tomorrow. Can't wait till the night. Can't wait till next week. Today, right now. Come. So, but I can't get to you. Just touch me right now. Reach your hand this way. Touch me through your speed right now. I need you. God, hear you right now. It's ours to extend. Yours to accept it. rejected. And his son. Jesus' name we pray. God bless you. We love you. Until we come again. In the name of Jesus, our Lord and our Savior. Amen.